Hi viewers, welcome to special episode on HYSEA Awards Conclave. హైదరాబాద్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ ఎంటర్ప్రైజెస్ అసోసియేషన్ 27th ఎడిషన్ అవార్డ్స్ ఘనంగా ముగిసింది. హైదరాబాద్ కేంద్రంగా ఐటీ సేవలు అందిస్తున్న అనేక చిన్న మధ్య తరహా సంస్థలను ప్రోత్సహించేందుకు హైసియా ప్రతి ఏటా అవార్డ్స్ ఇచ్చి ప్రోత్సహిస్తోంది. వివిధ కేటగిరీల్లో ఏడాది 30 మందికి పైగా అవార్డులు దక్కించుకున్నారు. ఈ కార్యక్రమానికి చీఫ్ గెస్ట్గా హెచ్సిఎల్ టెక్ మాజీ సీఈఓ సంపర్క్ ఫౌండర్ చైర్మన్ వినీత్ నాయర్ హాజరయ్యారు. విన్నర్స్ కు ఆల్ ది బెస్ట్ చెబుతూ కీలక ఉపన్యాసాన్ని చేసి వాళ్లకు దిశానిర్దేశం చేశారు.
Remote infrastructure management industry was created when the IP protocols made a lot of dumb devices manageable devices. And when dumb devices become manageable devices, new industry, and if you know that infrastructure management is now close to $20 billion export industry out of India, which didn't exist about a decade and a half ago. So there are a lot of use of sensors, and some of the startups were also experimenting with sensors. But I think the depth of technology and sensors, which you would see, is very large. And I believe Apple in the next decade will be a healthcare company largely driven out of sensing technologies. The second technology I'm very interested in is augmented reality, not virtual reality. The e-commerce industry, where you will consume an experience before you buy, education, multidimensional learning industry, it will change the agriculture industry using drone technology. I truly believe the augmented reality and the way especially Microsoft and Apple are looking at it, different to the way Google and Facebook are looking at it, I believe is a game changer. And the impact it would have on skill development, the impact it will have on maintenance organizations, the impact it will have on learning organizations is going to be quite profound in the next decade. Many people have talked about artificial intelligence, and that's an exciting technology, but I believe artificial intelligence, I'm excited on two count. One, it is going to try and, you know, take away jobs which are easy to do and which are repeatable, infrastructure management services, BPO, typical software maintenance, those jobs are going to go away to artificial intelligence. The computing power was the cornerstone of where all the engineering capability, a lot of that resides in Hyderabad, originated from. Now, computing industry and the ability to compute on programmable devices, wearable devices, is going through a colossal. The same amount of impact you saw on battery is happening on the computing. Therefore, the ability to do computing on smaller and smaller devices, which are mobile, is completely going crazy. Our margins from 25-30% are nearing 15-20%. Our legacy business continues to be greater than 70%. All these are the indicators when HP, CSC, EDS, we're talking about the fact that their business models will never get obsolete. This is exactly the matrix from which they dropped completely down.
సామాజిక సేవకు కేవలం డబ్బులు దానం చేయడం ఒక్కటే సరిపోదని గ్రౌండ్లో దిగి సమస్యలు తెలుసుకుని వాటికి సరైన పరిష్కారం చూపితేనే ప్రయోజనం ఉంటుందని చెప్తున్నారు వినీత్ నాయర్. ప్రస్తుతం ఉన్న పరిస్థితుల్లో పెద్ద ఐటీ కంపెనీల మనుగడ కూడా ప్రమాదంలో ఉందని, లీడర్షిప్ పొజిషన్స్ తారుమారైనా ఆశ్చర్యపోవాల్సిన పని లేదని చెప్తున్నారు. మరిన్ని ఆసక్తికర విషయాలను ఆయన టీవీ 5 బిజినెస్ ఎడిటర్ వసంత్ కుమార్ తో పంచుకున్నారు. ఆ ఎక్స్క్లూజివ్ ఇంటర్వ్యూ ఇప్పుడు చూద్దాం.
హైసియా ఇన్నోవేషన్ సమిట్ కి ముఖ్య అతిథిగా విచ్చేశారు శ్రీ వినీత్ నాయర్. He was a former CEO and vice chairman of HCL Technologies, and he is with us now. So, hi, Vinay sir, how are you?
Very good, very good.
So, after quitting HCL Technologies, what's your preoccupation now?
So, I quit HCL Technologies because I wanted to commit myself to the social cause. In India, we have 14 crore children in our government schools, about 6-7 lakh government schools.
Okay.
And learning outcome has deteriorated every year over the last decade, despite the fact that the funding in education has increased.
True.
A grade 5 child, 6 out of 10 cannot read grade 2 text, and 8 out of 10 cannot do simple math sum. This is the problem, you know, which attracted me and said I should spend a lifetime trying to solve this problem and invest my own resources to try and do it. So me and my wife started Sampark Foundation. Okay. And doing design thinking, frugal innovation, today we are in 76,000 schools, impact the lives of 7 million children through Sampark Smart Shala, which is an innovative program, mm-hmm. which is executed at less than $1 per child per annum.
Right.
And we hope to get to 200,000 schools and 2 crore children mm-hmm. by year 2020.
What's the kind of funding that you have earmarked for this?
So we have earmarked 650 crores
okay.
by 2025. That's mm-hmm. what me and my wife have committed to.
Okay.
The program.
It's completely funded by you or
yes, right
external
now, largely funded by me.
Okay. So we can call you now as a philanthropist.
Yes, that's what Forbes calls me.
Okay.
But I would like to call myself as a social innovator.
Okay.
Because just giving money is not good enough.
Yes.
You know, because in the end, in India, we have so many problems.
Mm.
They don't get solved just by cutting checks.
True.
We need more and more people to roll up their sleeves like Bill Gates has done.
Yeah.
And dedicate their time and energy and intellect to try and come up with innovative ideas which solves the social problem. Because in Sampark Smart Shala, for example, we've created an audio device. We've created a Mary Poppins kind of Sampark Didi. We've created interesting teaching learning material. We've leveraged technology to have mobile app with content which does not need internet.
Yeah.
So there are many design innovations mm-hmm. which combined with MOU with the government and executed at large scale. We train 2 lakh teachers every year, is how the change happens. So I think philanthropy or philanthropist doesn't explain it.
Okay.
I think it is important for more and more people to quit what they are doing at, you know, whenever they have made enough money
yeah.
and become social innovator. That to me is...
We have many such examples in the Western world, but not many from India. People like you, Mr. Premji, and we keep hearing about some of the names like this. And we have to have more such examples.
That's true. That's
so,
true.
You know how the situation is now. The economy is undergoing some severe crisis kind of a situation. We have seen some of the prominent business people committing, of course, that's only one instance as of now. But if we want this not to get deteriorated further, so what kind of steps should the government take?
One thing which is very positive, which has happened over the last 5 years, is the intention of the government and the focus on the government to try and create jobs and to get the economy back on rail is very, very sharp. So from that point of view, I would give it 10 out of 10 in terms of the intention is right. When you go to the strategy of execution, I think there are some missing pieces
yeah.
Which are now trying to get together. If you look at how would jobs get created and how would economy come back, I think it would come back if India's competitive index compared to the world increases. IT industry created millions of jobs predominantly because IT was competitive in the world index. So the question is, what kind of industries can India be competitive on? And I believe it can be competitive on shipbuilding because we have great shores. It can be competitive on healthcare, global tourism. It can be competitive on education. So I think we have to pick and choose the industries in which we believe India can be competitive
okay.
and invest heavily, like SEZs were created for IT industry. Create SEZs for these, you know, make sure that these infrastructure is created with no tax, with no custom duty. I think that kind of strategic investment over a long period of time in 5 or 6 chosen industries would solve the problem which this government is intending to do.
Mm-hmm.
So I believe the intention is right. This Make in India and some of these initiatives, the GST normalization are great initiative.
Yeah.
But I think it needs to take 1 more or 2 more big steps, which I'm sure this government is going to take.
With a strong mandate like...
Yeah, because they are focused on it. See, you know, once the government is focused on the problem, the matter is finding the solution, and sometimes it takes time.
True.
But at least what I'm happy is the government is focused on the problem.
True. But there's a severe liquidity crisis going on. The corporate India is now debt-ridden. It is burdened with a lot of debt. Even most successful organizations, the marquee names like G Group and some people like them are suffering now. So what should be done to come out of this kind of a crisis-ridden situation?
I'm not an economist and I'm not an expert in this field, but I would say that sometimes, you know, it happened in the 2008 collapse, financial collapse.
We've not affected that much compared to
the present
situation.
But what I'm saying is, if you take the 2008 collapse in America, a lot of debt was created and a lot of instruments were created, which created a fluff in the economy which was not true. And cleansing that was a painful experience, but that was cleansed by not over-investment by the government, but allowing the market to play itself and cleanse itself. Mm-hmm. And today we are in a much better shape economically and regulatory-wise than we were in 2008. And I believe we are going through the same. I think the extension of loans, you know, on phone calls, the NPAs, you know, all that is, you know, dirt created over the many decades of the past. Now, how do you solve it? We are in this situation, not created by any decades of a unique way of India doing business. I think you will have to allow it to cleanse itself. And I think there will be a pain in the short term, but you should allow that pain to play out predominantly because, you know, you created that mess. True. And then you should allow that mess to cleanse itself. That's what commerce is. That's what, you know, the companies will die. The companies will close down. The new next set of companies will be more careful. The banks who lose money will be more careful. They will not pick up the phones when they come. So I think we need to go through those 1-2 years of pain for us to create a new India, which works on a different mandate. So I'm not too concerned, because once you have to look at the country and you have to look at the markets, you should not see from a quarter, month, or a year perspective. You have to see from a multi-year perspective. It is true that our business principles were compromised. It is true that we were not doing business in the right way. We were not borrowing the right way. We were not lending the right way. Not the right people were getting the money. Now that whole cleansing has to happen, and it will be painful. So let's take this year as a painful year.
Right.
It's so better for the country.
So do you think that this is a short-term phenomenon and it will not last longer?
See, you have to understand that there is nothing which can stop India from being a 5 trillion economy. It may not happen in 5 years, it will happen in 10 years, right? But the question is, nothing can prevent, because if you see, where is the growth? The growth is coming from India, in China and India. So it's going to happen, but it's not going to happen if our institutions, judiciary, you know, government, lending systems, are not robust and are not world class. And therefore we have to go through judiciary cleanup, financial services cleanup, government and law and order cleanup, ease of doing business cleanup. So I think we are getting ready for us to move from the current state to that state. These cleanups are required, and therefore I'm not worried. No, I'm not worried. India, I'm very, very bullish and positive about India.
So where do you see the IT industry is heading towards in terms of growth? Because no more we are seeing the double-digit growth that we have seen in the late 90s and early...
Right. I think the IT industry is in a trap of its own making. Mm-hmm. I think we have become defensive rather than aggressive. When the IT industry was formed by people like F.C. Kohli, Premji, Shiv Nadar, Narayan Murthy, I think they were bringing appetite for risk. They were entrepreneurs. They were bringing an appetite to be able to do stuff which has not been done before, whether it was quality offshore delivery, infrastructure management, R&D services, BPO. All these industries were created when none existed. Sure. However, in the last decade, nothing new has been created. And therefore, the mindset has largely been conservative in terms of conserve what you have. So as we enter into the dark tunnel, where the entire industry has moved away from run the business, which is managing old legacy software, into change the business, which is the new digital disruptive technology, we are entering the dark tunnel and companies do not know how to respond. Now, if you enter a dark tunnel, historically we have pressed the accelerator when we enter the dark tunnel, and when we come out, we are not one, but we are two businesses.
Right.
Now, more and more companies are pressing the brake, because of which the growth has come down to single digits, employees have a negative growth on their salary, there is a 27% increase in compensation over the last decade, and inflation has increased by 116%, a net 7% per annum.
On the other side, the pricing pressure is...
Right, so, yeah. And margins have come down. So I think we are in a crossroad right now where either new companies will think about aggressively pursuing disruptive digital opportunities, because the overall market size is increasing. People are spending more and more IT.
Sure.
The product services which we are selling is decreasing, and therefore it needs a radical transformation of the organization, of its structure, of its people, of everything. And some companies will do it, others will not. And I think over the next decade, you will see the top 10 IT companies, the order will dramatically change, and some other companies will come to the top. But it is important at this juncture not to apply brakes and to demonstrate the same desire, hunger for growth. Without that, we will be single digit. This is exactly what happened to HP, EDS, CSC. True. All these companies died because they were in, you know, in the mode of not investing in the future.
So you expect a similar development here?
I definitely believe that the top 10 companies, there is going to be a radical change. Okay. Some companies in the top 10 are going to invest in the future. Some companies are going to focus on conserving their current positions, not taking aggressive risk, only talking about it. Those companies are not going to be in the top 10.
So what kind of investments do you will need to make?
I think the first is structural investments in terms of change the structure, create an old and a new organization. Number two is capital investment in the new, expect newer margins and treat it as startup environment and not run in the utilization pyramid structures of the old traditional ways. Number three, relocate that leadership of the new to US and Europe. Move them out of India, don't be India-centric. Number four, tie up with technology companies and startup companies which are creating new, unique capabilities and knowledge. Number five, create product and IP sales in the startup mindset, which are high risk in taking, and you invest as you would invest in capital. These are some structural departure from, we were a industrial age manufacturing company which runs the IT services with clockwork. We are very good at it, right? And we can squeeze efficiency.
Right.
However, the digital is not about efficiency. It is about creating value add. So the first port of call is to create a new structure. You cannot run a value creating digital organization in the old ways of running an efficient manufacturing organization.
True.
This is the reason most manufacturing organization could not go to services. So this is, I think, what needs to be done.
Okay, so we're running out of time. So finally tell me, when is Sampark coming to the Telugu states?
We want to. This is one of the reasons I was here. We have a unique offering where English is an aspirational language. We can teach English to children who have never heard of English. We can teach them 500 words in 1 year time. We have a unique audio device I was talking about. We teach maths in a very unique way. So hopefully we will have a conversation with the government here. And in case there is an interest, then we would like to work with them to adopt all the government schools in Telangana state and bring about a dramatic increase in learning outcome. That's my commitment to the country, and that's, I hope I can convince the government that, you know, we should focus on primary education,
right.
We should focus on innovation, and we should focus on change.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank
we
you.
Wish the Sampark Foundation all the best.
Thank you. Pleasure meeting
it's
you.
Nice meeting
thank
you. Sir. సంపద సృష్టించడం అనేది సొంత లాభం కోసం కాదు సమాజం కోసం అని నిరూపిస్తున్నారు హెచ్సిఎల్ టెక్నాలజీస్ మాజీ సిఇఓ అలాగే వైస్ చైర్మన్ వినీత్ నయ్యర్ 650 కోట్ల రూపాయలు ఆయన పిల్లల కోసం అందున దిగువ మధ్యతరగతి పేద విద్యార్థుల కోసం కేటాయించి వారిని విద్యావంతులు చేసే ప్రయత్నం చేస్తున్నారు చాలా అభినందనీయమైన పని ఇది సో లెట్స్ హోప్ మరింతమంది వినీత్ నయ్యర్ లాంటి వాళ్ళు మన సమాజానికి అవసరం మరింతమంది ఈ దిశగా ముందడుగు వేస్తారని ఆశిద్దాం ఇది వినీత్ నాయర్తో ప్రత్యేక ఇంటర్వ్యూ
హైసీ అవార్డ్స్ అందుకున్న విన్నర్స్ ఎక్స్క్లూజివ్ ఇంటర్వ్యూతో పాటు మరింతమంది ఇండస్ట్రీ ప్రముఖుల మనోగతాన్ని రేపు బిజినెస్ వీకెండ్ ఎపిసోడ్లో చూడొచ్చు ఇది హైసీ అవార్డ్స్ స్పెషల్ ఎపిసోడ్ స్టే విత్ అస్ ఫర్ లేటెస్ట్ అప్డేట్స్